Roberts Rules of Order, the I's have it. With Illinois State, the O's have it. Osiris Elridge, Champ Oguchi, and Dean Odiakosa. 11 days ago, the Illinois State Redbirds faced their in-state rival, Chris Lowry's Southern Illinois Salukis. At Redbird Arena, it was a battle to the finish, won by Illinois State. Tonight, less than 2 weeks later, the two teams meet again in Little Egypt. With Illinois State, it's Osiris Elridge, fifth in the league in scoring. He can fill it up from three or take you to the rack. Tonight, State Farm Insurance proudly presents our Missouri Valley Conference Game of the Week. Osiris Elridge and the Redbirds on the road to meet the Southern Illinois Salukis at SIU Arena in Carbondale. And good evening, everyone. I'm Mitch Holtis, along with the coach, Charlie Spoonhour. Southern Illinois will not have their great guard, Brian Mullins. So, Charlie, I got to ask you, how do you replace 509 assists, 254 steals, and 122 games?
Somebody can figure that out. They need to be back east working on the stimulus package. Not easy, but it starts with Dillard. Kevin Dillard has to step up, run the basketball team, add some assists, and continue to do his scoring, plus guard a little bit. He can do that, but it's going to be tough.
I said with the Redbirds, the O's have it. Another O for them is Champ Oguchi. Illinois State loves having him. Oregon is missing.
If Oregon's got players better than him, they got a heck of a ball club. He lit them up back at Illinois State when they played the first time. Shot the three well, drove it to the basket, and also rebounded. He is a really, really good player, and he's a tough matchup for anyone.
And you mentioned Dillard for Southern Illinois. There's some good freshmen in the league this year. This might be the best one.
He is as good a freshman for most of the time as you can find. Hare's not bad also. They're going to have three freshman guards out on the floor, Southern is, and that's pretty good.
And Southern Illinois, along with Kevin Dillard, you see his numbers. He's one of the better three-point shooters in the conference, although those numbers have drifted off here in the last couple of weeks. He'll play, might have to play 40 minutes tonight. All right, it's Illinois State here at SIU Arena. Southern Illinois in this building is 98-9 since the 2001-2002 season.
You know, it's not all fun and games when you're a mascot. Every year I find myself where the season always ends meets the bills never stop.
You know that place where you realize even a squirrel can't live off peanuts? Well, maybe you don't, but believe me, I'm there.
Here's a way to score on savings.
Nice.
Switch your car insurance to State Farm. You'll save big, plus get a payment plan that fits your budget. Call, click, or visit, and start saving today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You know I wear this everywhere.
Like that drinkability, huh? Drinkability means Bud Light's easy to drink. See, Bud Light goes down smooth like this guy here. But other beers go down like this guy. Is that really the best way to make your point?
Don't worry, nobody saw that.
The easy drinking taste of Bud Light. The difference is drinkability.
Trust me, chicks dig this.
Basically, it's about symmetry.
I'm good.
Be honest here, man.
Ah, fuck it.
I'm good.
My bad. I'm good.
I'm the man!
I'm good.
Ready? No.
Men can take anything.
I'm good.
Except the taste of Diet Cola. Until now, Pepsi Max, the first Diet Cola for men.
This is good.
Some of the most important decisions you make happen every day without much thought, and they can impact the rest of your life. Good decisions affecting your health can also happen outside of your doctor's office. They're made when you decide to work out or not, when you choose what to eat. We believe the more you know, the better choices you can make. Mercy Health Plans is here to help you with access, information, and guidance so you can make the best choices for your health. Mercy Health Plans, the way we care makes all the difference.
Tonight's Missouri Valley Conference basketball game is brought to you by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Bud Light, with just the right taste that never fills you up, the difference is drinkability. By Diet Pepsi, the official soft drink of the Missouri Valley Conference. By Mercy Health Plans, the way we care makes all the difference. And by Casey's General Stores, convenience stores, and a whole lot more. Tonight, the Valley is at SIU Arena in Carbondale, where in this building, The Salukis have been almost invincible in this decade, although this year it's been a little bit tougher on them. Illinois State in town tonight. Tim Jankovic in his second year as the head coach of Illinois State. Just keeping an eye on this guy and this name. 25 wins last year in his first year. That was the best in Illinois State history, and there have been some great coaches that have coached in Central Illinois for the Redbirds. Tonight's Bud Light lineup's presentation of Bud Light, the difference is drinkability. Southern Illinois will adjust by putting Bocock in the lineup. It'll be his first start. Hare is a very good freshman. We talked about Dillard. Fay and Boyle got to do something tonight inside for Southern to have a shot. And then this is an explosive Illinois State lineup. They can get it rolling from the perimeter. But overlooked on this team, and we'll talk about them tonight, are those guards, Lloyd Phillips and Emmanuel Holloway, somewhat underappreciated. And Chris Lowry, the only person in the history of civilization to win a Valley tournament as both a player and a coach, took Southern Illinois to the Sweet 16 in 2007 in this arena. He's only lost 12 times in his life as a player, assistant, and head coach. A great player here at Southern Illinois in the early 90s. Let's take a look at our Sirius history. It's brought to you by Sirius Satellite Radio. Everything we're listening to is now on Sirius XM. Visit Sirius.com. Of course, two in-state rivals they've met down through the years. They met again just 11 days ago. Illinois State's won the last three. Prior to that, Charlie, Southern Illinois had won the previous 11 games.
And Illinois State's had trouble on the road this year, Mitch. They've lost four straight, and they've got to find a way to turn that around and do it quickly.
To catch you up on the Redbirds, they started this year 14-0. That was a school record. Since then, they're 7-4 in league play, but you alluded to it, Charlie. They have yet to win a road game in the conference in this calendar year. They beat Missouri State before the turn of the year, but now they've gone since December 28th without a conference road win.
Well, and that gets on your mind, Mitch. That's the worst part of it. It eats on you, and you think, oh, how do we do? What do we have to do differently? Main thing is just play well.
And a look at another good freshman, Anthony Booker. They're going to have to play him more minutes tonight. Southern Illinois is down to just eight players on this team. Had a couple guys leave the program in early January. And now with the injury to their leader, Brian Mullins, Carlton Fay, Ryan Hare, and others are going to have to step up tonight. This is going to be a collective effort.
Told the trainer, Ed Thompson, if he goes out to get somebody, just stay out there because he's got to play.
Odiakosa and Boyle. Game on in America's Renaissance Conference, the Missouri Valley Conference. The first possession of the game is Southern Illinois. Boyle works against Odiakosa. Eldridge tries to dig it out. Southern Illinois will reset.
Nice.
Fay off the inside dish. Offensive board. Bocott working hard, but Odiakosa has got it for Illinois State.
Pretty good looks inside, though, for Southern, plus a very long possession, which we can expect quite a few of, I think.
Holloway, inside
nice.
Dribble, sets up
nice.
Odiakosa.
Phillips is going to chase and try to wear down Dillard. That's probably the idea tonight. Young man's just a freshman. This is a lot of basketball for him this year.
Let's be honest, when Brian Mullins was in the lineup, he was the guy rubbing off screens, trying to get passes. Now he's got to set everything up, handle the ball, and may have to play the entire game. Let's look at Charlie's State Farm keys to the game. Great service, great rates, it's all here. Nobody takes care of you like State Farm.
Well, I'll do this quickly. If you're Illinois State, handle the pressure. You can't turn it over 17 times on the road. That's what they did at home. The other thing they've got to do is make sure they're efficient with their offense, make sure they do stuff right. If you're Southern Illinois, grind it. And that's what they're doing on their offensive sets. Grind the thing out. Ooh.
Great no-look pass by Bocott. And the senior Tony Boyle couldn't handle it.
Hard matchup. You've got Oguchi and Fay. Fay a natural center.
And Oguchi throws it into the second row.
He had a look in the corner that time, and there was a wide open Osiris Eldridge. That wouldn't be a bad guy to throw it to.
Look at Champ Oguchi, transferred into the Illinois State program from the Oregon Ducks. 1 year of eligibility for Tim Jankovic's club, and he's paid off. Fourth in the conference and scoring at 15 a game. Can explode. He had 29 against Drake earlier this year when he hit seven threes. Perry's left-handed on the left side of the floor. Southern Illinois is getting okay looks. They just got to finish some stuff.
They've got to finish. That's exactly right. They're driving the ball to basket, and they're going to eventually draw some fouls, too, if they keep penetrating with the ball.
How about the adjustments now? You see Southern Illinois get up on Eldridge. But Chris Lowry's had to adjust with this team and the way he plays defense. Oh, Eldridge with the bucket.
That's just a nice move by Eldridge. A little crossover, and then hits the three. That's a big basket. Or a two, I guess. Excuse me.
First 4 points of the game, and Eldridge a little anxious and pushing hair out near the sideline. First foul of the game is on Valley star Osiris Eldridge.
I don't think you'll see any complaining from Tim Jankovic over a hustle play trying to deny a pass. I think that's, he'll accept that.
Jank, a little deeper on the bench, but not much. He's really shortened that bench this year, Charlie. Fay for three. And here's a foul on the ensuing board.
I don't think we have to belabor the point, but you can't get silly fouls if you're Southern Illinois. And that one, that's one you just give up on right there if you're Ryan Harris.
And there's the only three on the bench. We'll talk about them. That's Anthony Booker, Nick Evans, and Wesley Clemens. And that's it. You can look all over campus, and it's only those three.
This is the third screen set by Odia Costa in this possession, and it's only 15 seconds old.
There's
here comes
four.
And this batting's going to be illegal.
Now, if he's got hair on the grab, that's two quick ones on Ryan Harris.
And you'd have to say that this is, if you're Chris Lowry, this is what you don't want to see, the freshman mistake.
Chris Lowry has had to adjust this year, particularly defensively. He used to get right up on you, and this year he's had to back off a little bit with the fewer troops. Phillips on the take. They're going to count the basket. Give Lloyd Phillips a bucket and a foul in Southern Illinois.
And this is a penetration. Fay tries to draw the charge here. Apparently, feeling was he was not set. Those are tough. Those are sometimes hard to call.
Lloyd Phillips. He's hit 9 of his last 10 foul tosses. Tim Jankovic, we're talking today. I'm not sure people are talking enough about Phillips and Holloway. They have been better than solid this year.
They get assists. They do everything for, and they try to guard. That's the beauty of it.
Bocott loses Holloway on the dribble. Nearly gets pickpocketed by the aforementioned Phillips. 7-0 Illinois State.
Nice help and rotation that time by Illinois State.
Bocott is going to be called for a palming violation. And a rough start here for the Salukis, shorthanded anyway.
And the fans are still standing waiting on a bucket.
Stay tuned at halftime, Charlie. We're going to have our Cardinal Glennon Children's Medical Center report, where love for kids just keeps on growing. You'll be talking with both coaches. And a foul, and that's Diller trying to heat up Phillips, and in turn picks up his first, and four team fouls now on Southern Illinois before the first media break.
And it just reminded me that Nebraska, they stand until you make a basket. We kept them up one night for about 8 minutes. They weren't happy.
How many fainted when you scored?
I tried not to. Ooh, close. Illegal screen.
There it is. They finally got Odia Costa. He'd been looking for one in his six screens that he sets every possession.
That's as close to bumper cars as you're ever going to get right there.
Brandon Sampei comes in for Dima Odia Costa, native of Nigeria, for Tim Jankovic's team. Small court defense here by Illinois State. And the Salukis have got to figure out a way to score.
Another good overplay by Eldridge that time.
Clemens, that's a hard take. He's going to get free throws.
It's the last ball game at Illinois State. When Clemens came in the ball game, he did that very thing right there. Took it hard to the basket, got himself to the line. I think there's a lot of basketball in him that just hasn't come out yet.
It has been a frustrating year for Wesley Clements. His numbers are down as Oguchi is called for the foul for Illinois State. You look at his scoring numbers. I mean, last year he had 24 in a game against Western Kentucky. This year his season high is 12. He's got Southern Illinois in the scorebook. He splashes another one home again, and Chris Lowry's club has two free throws. 7-2 Illinois State. Now it's Sam Pay's turn to screen.
And Odiokosa. There's the lob.
Good left turn. Odiokosa not there, and Pay with just enough defense on the board.
Here's where the Salukis need a little help. Is out of their post, people. Fay and Boyle need to get some baskets for them on the interior.
In their best games this year, Charlie, let's be honest, that's a good look for Dillard.
Oh.
In their best games, those two bigs have had good games. They beat UMass, which is a heck of a win. Fay had 17. Boyle's had 14 three different times. Phillips, Holloway, and the kick out. He's robbed by the rim.
Good rebound by Fay. Last ball game against Illinois State, Fay had no rebounds. So this is a great improvement.
Boyle and Fay both good at Wichita State in a road win for Southern. Bocott, a three. He is five for his last 15. Southern Illinois needed that from the sophomore. He's from Bloomington. Of course, Bloomington Normal, the Twin Cities, the home of Illinois State.
Southern right back in the middle of this game.
And a turnover as Illinois State sped up. So Southern took a while to score, but they're within a bucket at the first break.
All good at Casey's General Stores. Right now, buy any large specialty pizza and get any medium single topping pizza for only $8.
Made fresh for your order. Need the cheese piled high for you. Casey's General Store. Casey's, it's all good.
Connecting Missouri with 27,000 miles of power lines means each and every mile must be reliable. Because when the skies turn dark, every mile must show its strength. We're Ameren UE, working every day, improving our delivery system. UE, ratcheting up our routine so you can enjoy undisturbed comfort in yours. Learn how we're improving reliability at uepoweron.com.
So this is another opportunity to take the foundation, take these young men, and build them their lives and build something special.
Right, when I came in and took this position, I said, this is what we're going to do, and this is where we're going to be. This program is solid. It is successful. You're going to see that determination and that defensive intensity on the floor.
Did you know companies who advertise during economic uncertainty grew their sales 250% over companies who didn't? Now is the best time to advertise your product and services. Comcast Spotlight provides a cost-effective way to grow your business. Advertise on cable television and reap huge dividends on your investment. Maintaining brand awareness costs much less than rebuilding it. To advertise your business, call me, Janet Armstrong, or Jim Cahill.
7-5 Illinois State, one of the best guards in Southern Illinois history, will be Brian Mullins. He is out for this game and out indefinitely with a stress fracture in his foot, and it's a shame, Charlie.
He's a really good player and a great kid, 4-point student, He's worked so hard through his 4 years to enjoy this season, and only can hope that he'll be back for the end of the year.
Look at this, 509 assists, 254 steals. Second player in Valley history to accumulate those totals. He has been part of some great teams and great moments here at Southern Illinois. I hope he gets back at some point to play his senior season. So does Chris Lowry.
Yeah.
Anthony Booker in the game now, the highly acclaimed freshman from St. Louis. He's got the ball now in the post as Odiakosa guards him. Nine to shoot. Boca again works that left side. That's a nice play.
Ran a shot clock down, Mitch. After the timeout, came with a little bit of a set action that time. Did Southern.
Sead Odzik in the game now. The USC transfer trying to create something inside, and that's off of Illinois State. So right now the Redbirds have a few little turnover issues.
Well, that was the issue last ball game. They get a run, get ahead, then they turn the basketball over. They've got four of them now, and that's too many for this type ball game. Mitch, you can't guard 30 seconds and then have to come down and turn the ball over. It just absolutely wears you out.
Bocott has been aggressive. Booker, too many hands. Feet. This is out off Booker. He thought Illinois State touched it last. Instead, it'll go to the Redbirds.
And that's one thing that's overlooked in Eldridge's game this year. Help defense there. We've already watched him overplay. That was one of the things he worked on. That's what the coaches wanted him to do, and he's certainly done it.
Illinois State started with a 7-0 lead. Their last five possessions have resulted in three turnovers and two missed shots. And no offensive boards. They're the best in the Valley at it. They lead the rebound margin in the league. Air ball, held ball that's going to go to Illinois State.
Redbird basketball.
Tim Jankovic, his team, 14 times this year has had 10 or more offensive rebounds. So far tonight, Southern Illinois has prevented that.
Southern Illinois has done a good job on the board. They've done a good job defensively after the first two or three possessions.
Gucci's setting down right now. Eldridge, that's going to go to Southern Illinois. The arrow just switched.
That's considered a jump ball.
That was a hard shot, and people probably wonder why he shot that basketball so quickly. There were only 2 seconds on the shot clock when the thing ended, so that was a forced shot.
Jampo Gucci, Osiris Eldridge's running mate, setting down with two personal fouls. He got his second foul at the 16-14 mark.
Did it last game also.
Dillard trying to create something. Great lean, and the freshman has got his first two of the night. In league play, he's averaging 15 points a game, the leading freshman scorer in the conference. Game tied at 7. The Redbirds had the first 7. The Salukis were the last 7.
Things are just a little out of sync right now for the red shirt.
As you say that, they turn it over for the fifth time.
Phillips is looking for centers inside. You don't fault him for trying to get it inside, but he's not meshing with them right now as to where the ball ought to go.
Phillips sets down. Holloway takes his place. Those two kind of interchangeable parts at that 1 and 2 position. Here's a 7-0 run of the last 5. Dillard makes that a 9-0 run. He only had 7 in normal, Charlie. That's his 2-month low in that game 11 days ago. Tonight he looks different.
You always wonder how a guy's going to come back the second time you play. And if you've done a good job on him, you've got to think, if he's a good player, and we know he is, you're probably in trouble.
Bad pass. Odzik throws it right to Nick Evans. And the turnovers mount for Illinois State.
Whoa,
beautiful cross by Dillard.
Well, that was an adventure right there.
Eldridge, he's been cold. Odzik chases it down.
Nice. all night. Let's go.
Lead pass, Bocott, Wild, Booker, foul.
That was a break there because that the game got away a little bit.
Illinois State has 7 points and six turnovers at the 10:58 mark.
Where can you get the best milk? From Tom, from Russ, from Laura, and Maggie.
It comes from all of us.
We're Prairie Farms, and we don't just work for the dairy. We are the dairy, making sure the milk in your child's school, in your stores, and on your table is fresh and healthy, handled with the kind of care that your family deserves.
We are Prairie Farms Dairy.
Ask for us, the farmer-owned dairy.
It might just take a little something different, a break from the norm, ordinary clock ticking, same time, same old, with the flick of a switch, a new light, new mood, new tone, new pitch, voila, pleasurable indeed, oh yeah, satisfy my need, all right, how I long to be, my soul on fire, my spirit free, whoa, whoa, yeah, yeah, whoa, whoa.
I know this drill. I rack up a big charge on my credit card. I get a tote bag.
Well, actually, with our points program, you can get gift cards, flat screen TVs, even plane tickets.
How do you get enough points for that?
Oh, all kinds of ways. By using your debit card, your credit cards, checking account.
I don't believe you.
What?
You're messing with me, right?
No, I'm not messing with you.
Can I still get the tote bag?
Absolutely.
It's not just banking. It's National City.
Gatorade presents tonight's Valley Legends. Southern Illinois' Darren Brooks, one of the toughest players to ever play in the Valley. He owns Saluki career steals marked with 258 steals. Back-to-back Larry Bird Valley Player of the Year selection. He also earned Defensive Player of the Year and All-Conference honors in 2004 and 2005. He led Southern Illinois to four trips to the NCAA tournament, including a 2002 Sweet 16 run. Darren Brooks of Southern Illinois, tonight's famous Valley alum. Gatorade, is it in you? Darren Brooks was good. The Southern Illinois Salukis leading 9-7 at 10:58 to go in the first half. Let's salute tonight's Prairie Farms Valley Scholar athlete. It's Illinois State's Dina Odiakosa, a junior forward from Nigeria. Last year, he was big in the NIT, including that win over Utah State, averaging 13 points a game. He's got a little over a three-point average in telecommunications management. Congratulations to Dina Odiakosa, the Prairie Farms family of dairies. Prairie Farms, Highland Roberts Dairies, serving dairy fresh food products throughout Mid-America. All right, I misspoke. Illinois State has 7 points and seven turnovers in the game, Charlie. It has been a drought for Tim Jankovic Redbirds.
6 minutes and 16 seconds. They have gone 0 for 3, 0 for 1 on a 3, and that was the one that was taken late in the shot possession. But the turnovers are exactly what's killing the Redbirds.
Illinois State started 3 for 3 from the field. Since then, 0 for 6 with 6 turnovers. Anthony Booker, freshman at the line, not real good at the line, just 57%.
Well, foul issues have obviously slowed down Illinois State, but Ryan Harris sitting on the bench for Southern also.
And Champ Oguchi had 2 early fouls for the Redbirds, which forced him to the bullpen. Kellen Thornton is in the game now for Illinois State. A freshman from the Chicago area.
That's the third center.
Thornton way off, wide left. He's only scored 7 points all year.
I doubt that that would be the shot that the ball coaches would have wanted that on that possession.
Dillard.
Nice.
Great pass to Bocott.
Nice.
Eldridge with the board. He gets 6 a game.
He's good right here, Mitchell. He brings it down and sort of speculates a little. He's a good player.
Here's a foul from behind. Evans reaching around. Brandon Sampe. Big Nick Evans, 6'11". Interesting story. Closed captioning for tonight's game, made possible by Emerson, the global manufacturing and technology company. To learn more, visit Emerson.com. Emerson, consider it solved.
Evans's problem then, he just ran down the floor and lined up behind the man. Obviously, that's not going to work.
He was homeschooled. He really didn't start playing basketball much until his sophomore year. Southern Illinois thinks he's got a big upside. Phillips, tough shot. Boyle with enough help. Quick to the other end. Clemens scoops. Bucket.
And there's Clemens again going to the goal, Mitch. And he's a good player when he does that. Strong. He can finish at the goal. Watch him here. He's going to get bumped.
16 on the reserve.
Just lays her in.
Second foul on Emmanuel Holloway of Illinois State. That's 16 fouls on the Redbirds. We watch his first 3 minutes of this game, you're thinking, man, Illinois State might win by 20. Now you watch the last 7-8 minutes, and you're thinking, man, Southern Illinois might win by 20.
Oh, look at that.
Tip and fade. That's a four-point trip. 13 unanswered points for Southern Illinois.
Well, the freshman Thornton got lit up on that one. Just didn't keep the big fella off.
Alex Rubin is in now as Tim Jankovic goes a little deeper on his bench. Foul issues have caused Jank to call for some numbers near the end of the bench. Last 8 minutes, a 13-0 run, 8 to shoot. Who's going to score out of this group? Extra pass, deep, and he walks. Illinois State has not scored, Charlie, since Champ Oguchi sat down with his second foul.
And he's probably going to be there a while, so somebody better figure out what they're doing. This is one of those deals right now where Tim Jankovic is just looking down that bench saying somebody has got to step up and play.
And give Southern Illinois a lot of credit, Charlie. They have really adjusted after a rough start to this game. Boyle faces a double. Brandon Foltz is in the game now for Illinois State. Hare.
Block.
And that's first bonus. Foul's going to go against Alex Rubin. Of Illinois State and the Salukis go to the first bonus at 8:44 the first half.
Southern's taking the ball at the basket. And they're doing a good job of it, and they're getting baskets, and they're getting free throws.
Holtz, Rubin. We've already seen Thornton. I mean, these are guys that just haven't played much over the last 6 or so weeks for this team. Those guys have, but they're sitting down right now.
Dillard's going to get what's known as a quick break.
Hare, free throw. He's really good at that, 82%. Got off to a great start in his career at the foul line.
Let's see if Faye can get in on another rebound because he's got a smaller guy this time.
Doesn't need to.
Nope.
15 straight points for Southern Illinois.
This is one of the times where you need to find something to get your best player a chance.
Bocott reaches in. That's a 16 foul on Southern Illinois. Bocott is called for the foul. It's just his first.
Well, this is a different lineup that Tim Jankovic has got in there now.
Eldridge, Clemens got his hand on him. It'll be 1-1 for Osiris Eldridge.
Smart play by a very good player, taking the ball to basket and trying to get something to happen. Yeah, we watched him wrapping his ankle about midway in the first quarter. Doesn't seem as though it's bothering any right here.
Illinois State had the train derail a little bit. They won their first 14 games. It looked like, ooh. Then they went through some... Oguchi had back trouble. Eldridge got sick. They had some flu issues. And finally, Illinois State is back in the scoring column. It took them a while. But they've gone through now some sickness and some injuries. But they've had a couple guys in and out over the course of the last 2 months.
Well, if anyone questioned how Chris Lowry's team was going to come out and compete, I think they've got the answer right here.
Now, what makes it impressive is they were bad to start the game. First 3 minutes, it looks like, they're not going to respond real well, but they have been outstanding here over the last several minutes.
And I would credit the young man with the ball with a little of it, taking the ball to basket, making stuff happen.
Tip in again.
And the big guys, Mitch, you said it before the ball game, the big guys have to step up and get something done.
Illinois State went 9 minutes without scoring. 9 minutes. They have 9 points. Eldridge, toe on the line. Hare with the board.
Excellent box out by Boyle. Kept Sampay off the board.
Boyle was good at Wichita State in a road win, as I mentioned.
Defense. Nice. Sampay had 9 rebounds at Illinois State and 5 points.
Holtz, this would be a bonus. I'll tell you, Tim Jankovic is down there thinking, do I bunt the guy, suicide squeeze? I cannot figure out a way to score.
Bunny with 2 strikes here. This is a hard time. Set play right here. Try to get Dillard to look.
Dillard, former.
Nice.
Last touch by Sampay. 6:52 to go in the half, and Southern Illinois has flipped this game around.
The distinctive taste of Bud Light can be described with just one word. Drinkability. Bud Light. The difference is drinkability.
Your dog's one of a kind.
Good boy.
And now, you have the power to help significantly extend his healthy years. A groundbreaking 14-year study by Purina proves that Puppy Chow, then Dog Chow Nutrition, fed properly over a lifetime,
ready, Axel?
Can help extend his lovable antics up to 1.8 healthy years.
Faster, Axel, faster!
Long live your buddy. Long live your dog. Purina Puppy Chow and Purina Dog Chow.
The Missouri Valley Conference celebrates athletic excellence, bringing you nonstop red-hot collegiate basketball. There's another team in town that we're privileged to support, the Bob Costas Cancer Center at Cardinal Glennon Children's Hospital. The Cancer Center provides state-of-the-art technology, a child-friendly environment, and compassionate care to children who are diagnosed with cancer and other blood disorders. The Missouri Valley Conference and the Bob Costas Cancer Center. We're here for the kids. Give us a hand. The not too heavy, not too light taste of the one beer that's always easy drinking. Bud Light. The difference is drinkability.
Fellas, I'm just waiting for an email. I'll be just a minute.
No problem. So, by the way, great job today.
I mean, it wasn't too hard. Yeah.
Was that your email notification?
Yeah.
I never had you pegged for a quack guy.
You don't think it's funny?
It's really funny.
Oh, it is funny, yeah. I like Doug.
Southern Illinois leading 17-9 at 6:52. Good on the first half. Illinois State had a 7-0 lead to start the game. Let's look at the Valley standings here, Charlie. Brought to you by Peabody Energy, the world's largest coal company and an innovative, growing supplier of low-cost energy. Northern Iowa, Ben Jacobson, threatening to run and hide.
He certainly is, and I think everybody kept saying, well, they're going to lose the game, rather like we did last year with Drake. And it just sometimes doesn't happen that way.
And they're winning road games. They were down 8 points with 4 minutes to go at Bradley, a hard place to win, and won the game.
And a freshman nails it.
Moran, very good. That's an excellent team to watch. If you haven't seen Northern Iowa, watch them. And this is huge. 8 turnovers by Illinois State. Clemens, 3. Eldridge over the back, reaching over Justin Bocott. Second foul on Eldridge. So now the O's have 2. Osiris Eldridge with 2. Champ Oguchi had 2 early. Here's a look at Champ Oguchi. 17 in the game 11 days ago. He's not played much tonight.
4 minutes.
Bocott gets the coupon. It's Southern Illinois in the bonus. His mom works for State Farm, and we know the intergalactic headquarters of State Farm is in that Bloomington-Normal area. He was a non-qualifier. He paid his own way to school last year. Was on campus here. And now on scholarship at Southern Illinois.
Yeah, looks like a good offensive player, Mitch. He's quick. And being left-handed doesn't hurt you.
Although he bowls right-handed. How's that look?
He bowls right-handed?
Yeah.
How did I miss that?
Illinois State has gone 10-33 without a field goal, Charlie. They have just the two free throws from Osiris Eldridge. That's it.
Well, I'd like to tell you I know how to get one, but obviously I wouldn't have, or I'd still be coaching. Oh, my.
Boyle, 1-1 for Odiakosa.
But although you don't want your big guys getting fouls, this is a pretty good place to put Odiakosa. He's 42% on the year.
One and one as everybody readies for the rebound.
This time everybody's serious about screening out.
Nothing. Nothing but net.
Well, the shot doesn't look bad, Mitch. You know, he just has trouble getting it to stay in the basket.
He leads the Valley in field goal shooting percentage at 63%. In fact, he's in 71% in his last nine games. And knocks two down like he's Blake Ahern.
He's doing the, isn't it Wood Fox that does the step up?
Yeah,
he's got the Wood Fox.
With the Wood Fox's clinic. Now you got a zone with Illinois State.
Well, you do that and you hope you slow down Southern. You also try to keep Eldridge from picking up a third foul.
Dillard's looking at this zone, hoping to get a shot against it. And there's a steal. Brandon Pulse.
A rare turnover for the Salukis after the first part of the game.
Eldridge a quiet four, but he can get him in a hurry just like that.
If you're Southern right now, you say, oh my, don't let him get started, don't let him get a run.
First field goal for Southern Illinois in almost a 12-minute span. Faye gets knocked down, and this is Odiakosa. Called for the arm bar. That's his second.
Odiakosa does not get cheated on his fouls.
Jeremy Robinson into the game for Illinois State. Anthony Booker into the game for Southern Illinois, replacing Tony Boyle.
11 players for Tim Jankovic, and we've still got 5:28 to go in the first half.
Fade to the line. He's not bad at these. It's 78%. At intermission, we will have our Cardinal Glennon Children's Medical Center halftime report, where love for kids just keeps on growing. Charlie will be talking with both coaches during the halftime feature. I'm sure Tim Jankovic will be just thrilled and ready to talk to you about offense.
Yes, I think I may stay away from the offensive question for right now.
8-point lead, Southern Illinois. And they started off with a 7-0 deficit. Eldridge had a look in his eye like he wants to get something done. Foul. Sam Pay runs over Anthony Booker.
Anthony Booker's learned a few things sitting over on the side a lot this year. Figured out when a guy goes back into you, fall down and get the call.
They call Southern Illinois Floor Burn U. They're famous for their floor burns at practices. They take charges. Chris Lowry's done a great job with this team. I had him early against Drake. They got nailed. They started 0-3 in conference play, and I thought, Charlie, they're in real trouble. And they have rallied, and now they got to rally again without Mullins. But sometimes you do your better coaching jobs when you just try to keep the boat in the water.
You're exactly right, because this with a short bench and even shorter tonight. He's just done wonderful.
I wonder if Tim Jankovic thought he'd be playing Brandon Hulse, Jeremy Robinson, and Sam Pay all at the same time late in the first half.
Well, let's see what happens this time.
Bucket.
Whoa, nice shot.
Sam Pay with the hook. He can do it. He had 14 on the last Valley Road win for Illinois State at Missouri State.
Zone again.
Well caught out of rhythm.
Oh, my.
And a real hard checkoff. Phillips. I don't know where Sam Payne was going.
Phillips has done that, though, two or three times tonight. He's taken the ball inside, given it to the big guy, and he's had trouble.
They got everything.
Not everything.
That's not mine.
Yo, Rich, he said he saw two guys earlier. One of them was wearing a jacket.
And how does that help me?
Yo, you cover for this?
I don't know.
How could you not know?
Yo, it's not funny.
This is funny. You know what? You need to call my agent.
You should know you're covered.
Come on, man. It's not mine.
Call one of our 17,000 State Farm agents today.
Combining historic ambiance with modern comforts, the Sheraton St. Louis City Center Hotel and Suites has something for everyone. Spread out in one of our beautifully appointed guest rooms, relax at our indoor heated swimming pool, or grab a bite to eat in Bistro 14, where our chef serves up American-style entrees. With over 29,000 square feet of meeting space and a ballroom with spectacular views of the downtown skyline, our facilities are the choice for your next event. The Sheraton St. Louis City Center Hotel and Suites. You don't just stay.
What's so great about a Thursday? At Terrible's, every Thursday is great. Use your Terrible's Players Club card and get four times the points. Then redeem those points for great gifts. And every Friday in February, five winners will walk away with cash prizes or a trip for two to Las Vegas. Four times points Thursdays and Vegas Voyage Fridays all this month at
Terrible's, the best in town. Oh, yeah.
Avoiding coin laundries? Don't. Look for five-star rated laundries instead. Your assurance of the best care in the business. Look for the five-star laundry symbol in your neighborhood.
Illinois State, 21-15, 3:52 to go in the first 20. When Metro Sports takes its cameras on the road, these properties are the home away from home. Call this hotel, visit the website, these properties when following your favorite Valley team away from home. All right, Illinois State has lost four straight road games in the league. Look at this, Charlie. At home, from three. This is a good three-point shooting team. 43%. On the road, 30%. Tonight, 0%. That is a donut for the Redbirds from three. 0 for 4 from three-point range.
And they were 50% the last time these two teams met. Of course, now, when Oguchi comes back, that can change.
Southern Illinois with 10 paint points, just 4 for the Redbirds in the corner. Dillard waits, leaves it short. Sam Pay's got to be careful. Southern Illinois is in the double bonus.
Careful is not in Sam Pay's vocabulary.
Bocott. Foul on his way to the basket. Bocott's been good tonight.
Bocott's
going to the basket.
Been very good. And the Salukis have done a nice job of chasing down rebounds and then extending possessions again. And keeping Illinois State on the defensive end.
Fouls on Brandon Hulse, who hasn't had this many minutes since his summer league game about 4 years ago. Free throw down Bocott. He's 3 for 3 at the line. Had 14 and normal to go along with 8 rebounds. In fact, he's led him in scoring in 2 of the last 3 games. This is a good sign for Chris Lowry to see this guy elevate his game.
Well, somebody, as we talked earlier, somebody has to step up.
Strong rebound by Jeremy Robinson. He came into the game with 6 rebounds total for the year.
People sometimes have to change their game a little bit, and that can work to your disadvantage as a player when you try to do a few things that maybe aren't comfortable with.
And a steal, Booker, another turnover. 11 Illinois State turnovers in this half.
The idea was good right here. Sam Pate just not strong enough holding the man off. And another good play by the freshman.
Booker looking much different than he did a month ago.
Oh, I'd say. Kim Jankovic is trying to steal some minutes.
Another turnover. Bocott Evans. Nick Evans, the homeschooler, with the dunk. And they celebrate here in Carbondale. Again, it bears repeating. In the first 3 minutes of this game, Illinois State led 7-0. But Bocott, waiting for his chance to pick Lloyd Phillips, and it set up the big fella at the other end to get everybody excited. Evans, who grew up about 180 miles from here on a farm. Here's what he's got to go through. His mom is going to school at Southern Illinois the same time he is. Imagine running into your mom on campus. But here's the guy so far in this game. Your MVP is Justin Bocott. A very good line for the sophomore from Bloomington, Illinois. Again, they're sitting in the backyard of Illinois State. The two big guns for the Redbirds, Champo Gucci. No points. He's only played 4 minutes. Foul trouble. And Osiris Eldridge with just 6 points. Robinson, Sam Pay, there's a 3-second violation. It might have been a 6-second violation, because I think both Robinson and Sam Pay were in there at the same time. Tim Jankovic, calm and collected. He's an outstanding college basketball player at Kansas State. He's worked for some of the best in the business. But tonight, he's trying to figure out and reach back to all of his background to try to figure out what to do. Down 9 points with a minute 44 to go in the first half. And driving and scoring is Jeremy Robinson. That is only his 7th and 8th points of the season for Illinois State, the freshman from Decatur, Illinois. Charlie, again, that's 8 points for the year for Robinson.
That was a good basket to get right there, Mitch. A run out. That's important.
Evans can't handle it. And Illinois State's trying to get by here without Oguchi or Eldridge on the floor or Emmanuel Holloway. I mean, Tim Jankovic has the JVs out there right now to try to end this half. Exception of Phillips. He's a starter. He's got the ball right now. Phillips, good look at a 3, leaves it short. Bocott's at a heck of a half. Differential. Dillard. Started off to be great on 3s. And Bocott's hustle play leads to a foul on Sam Pay. Dillard, 2 of his last 17 from 3.
Justin Bocott has the line for the blue team.
Bocott showing his length there, Charlie. Bocott has been very good for Chris Lowry in this first half.
He's been really good. The rebounding has been excellent for the smaller Salukis. They've really done a nice job.
missing. Illinois State with no threes in the game. In fact, Southern only has one. Bocott is the only guy in this game in the first half with a three.
And the fouls, Mitch, continue to mount for Illinois State.
Bocott leads all scorers with seven. It is an eight-point lead for Southern Illinois.
If you're Illinois State, Mitch, you don't want Southern Illinois to have the ball back at all.
But you'd like to get a look here, and you've turned it over 13 times in the first half. Almost 14.
Yes, it was.
Ten seconds left in the half. Holtz for three. Loose ball. Who's going to get this? Illinois State's got an underneath inbounds with 3.2. I'm curious if you'll put Oguchi or Eldridge in. Nope, he's not. He's going to stay with this crew.
Well, the out-of-bounds play where they lob it in to the center is a slow-developing play. That's going to call for Sam Pay to make a play with 3 seconds to go.
Illinois State started 3 for 3. They've since been 3 for 15. They're not going to get an attempt.
Oh, my.
That would have finished Bocott's half perfectly. 25-17, Southern Illinois. Outscoring Illinois State 25-10. Let's go to Charlie Spooner with a happy Chris Lowry.
Chris, many things to talk about. Clemens gave you a good lift. You defended the threes. You hustled. You rebounded. Not much else you can ask kids to do.
No, we had five freshmen out there quite a bit, and, you know, we just got to keep guarding like we can.
Great job.
Thank you.
Chris Lowry trying to get another win at home. He's lost here 12 times in his life. That includes being a player, head coach, and assistant. Our chat with the coaches all year brought to you by Mercy Health Plans, an innovative health management company empowering members to make healthy choices. The way we care makes all the difference. Big half for Justin Bocott. The Egyptian Dogs are barking tonight. They lead by 8.
Everything worth listening to is now on Sirius XM. 69 commercial-free music channels. The most talk, news, and entertainment. Every major sport. New programming, new choices, new prices. Over 130 channels. Add the best of Sirius to your XM subscription or the best of XM to your Sirius subscription free for 3 months. Hear what over 35 million listeners can't get enough of. Sirius XM.
Thank you for flying with Saluki. We hope you'll join us again soon. Southern Illinois University.
If your basement or crawl space leaks when it rains, the reoccurring mess can be unbearable. Hang up that mop and put away the shop vac after calling Helitech. They install the Hydroway basement waterproofing system. A guaranteed solution. Call Helitech and
heal your home with Helitech.
Missouri Valley basketball snaps into focus on Fox Sports Midwest. The Drake Bulldogs. The Bradley Braves. Saturday at 8 Eastern, 7 Central on Fox Sports Midwest. Blues, Oilers, Thursday at 7 in high definition on Fox Sports Midwest.
Tonight's Missouri Valley Conference basketball game is brought to you by State Farm. Great service, great rates, it's all here. Nobody takes care of you like State Farm. By Sirius Satellite Radio, everything worth listening to is now on Sirius XM. By Diet Pepsi, the official soft drink of the Missouri Valley Conference. And by the Prairie Farms family of dairies. Prairie Farms, Highland, and Roberts Dairy, serving dairy-fresh food products throughout Mid-America. Welcome back to Carbondale, Illinois. They are awarding the Southern Illinois Salukis the Valley Football Championship here at halftime. And our Cardinal Glennon Children's Hospital halftime report, Southern Illinois leading Illinois State by a score of 25-17. Mitch Holt is back with you along with Charlie Spooner. Okay, no Brian Mullins. You're down 7-0. You have a brutal start to the game. What about the competitive effort of Southern Illinois in the last 17 minutes of that half?
Excellent. Just absolutely excellent. Came out, it's fish or cut bait time, and they decided to fish. And they played hard, both ends of the floor. And I tell you, the fouls just kept mounting for Illinois State. This is a great half if they can continue the effort.
Illinois State has 17 points, 14 turnovers, and 12 fouls. Four of their five starters have two fouls. That carries over to the second 20.
Well, there's no question. And this is one of those situations where if Oguchi, I'm telling you, he only played 4 minutes. If he goes out and starts playing and doesn't pick up fouls, he can make up 6 or 7 points so quickly.
Well, this is a great football conference, too. In fact, very, very competitive in the FCS. And there's a look at the trophy given to the Southern Illinois Salukis. You win football in this league, it's a six and something. Southern Illinois leading by 8 at halftime.
When we give a child the ability to read, it's a gift that will last a lifetime. At State Farm, we're pleased to be part of the Missouri Valley Conference effort to help young people build their reading skills. Children pay attention when student athletes show how much fun it is to read and how reading skills are so fundamental to doing well in other school subjects.
On clear days, the sun's rays.
Launched in 1998, the Just Read program is a community outreach endeavor co-sponsored by the Missouri Valley Conference and State Farm Insurance.
Betsy came running down the ramp, threw her arms around George, and kissed him.
Recently, student-athletes from Illinois State University read to grade school students at Pepper Ridge Elementary School in Bloomington, Illinois.
I think if when I was younger in this age and we had a program like this, that I think I would want to read a lot more and it'd be inspiring to me.
I had an idea to walk backward all the way home from school.
I hope kids learn that, you know, reading can be fun, you know. It doesn't have to be just for school, but you can find a subject that you're interested in. You know, books are fabulous.
When you're that age, it's perceived to be boring to read, and if they see us college athletes coming in here saying that we like to read and that it's important, that they'll take that away from him.
State Farm proudly presents the Just Read program.
The legend was born in 1965 in the storied swamp of Florida, where the scorching heat took a brutal toll on the Gators.
The players weren't adequately hydrated, and their performance suffered.
The answer, a new carbohydrate electrolyte beverage created by University of Florida doctors.
Naturally, we called our stuff Gatorade.
And when they won the 67 Orange Bowl, Gatorade had arrived. Born of humble origins, proven to this day. The legend continues.
March 5th, March Madness returns to St. Louis, and the Missouri Valley Conference is gearing up for another successful event. This year, Prina Dogchow has a way for Valley fans to get a deal on Arch Madness tickets. At participating Schnucks and Hy-Vee grocery stores in Metro St. Louis and MVC cities, buy one 17-pound or larger bag of Prina Dogchow and get a coupon good for the purchase of two single-session tickets for $15. That's right, two tickets for $15. Save on Arch Madness tickets by stopping by your local Schnucks or Hy-Vee store today.
When marching to the Arch to attend the 2009 State Farm MVC Tournament in St. Louis, Valley fans can join their teams at their headquarter hotels. Conveniently located near attractions like the Gateway Arch, 10 downtown team properties offer MVC rates to fans wishing to follow their schools all the way to the Valley Tournament title. To book rooms at these properties for Arch Madness or for your next trip to St. Louis, call 1-800-916-0041 or visit Explore St. Louis.
You've trusted Auto Tire for the best price on the best tire brands. Trust Auto Tire for your service needs, too. Services like oil changes, brakes, and alignments performed by ASE-certified technicians. For service you can trust, you ought to go to Auto Tire, the tire pros.
Tonight on the best damn sports show, period. It's the most jaw-dropping sound in sports.
I did not bet on baseball.
It's BetSam's Top 50, you gotta hear this moment.
Albert!
Not 11 Central, midnight Eastern.
Welcome back to our Cardinal Glennon Children's Halftime Report. Southern Illinois leading Illinois State 25-17. Let's take a look at our halftime stats and presentation from production of National City. It's not just banking, it's more rewards. All right, turnovers big. Illinois State at 14 of those, leading to 9 Southern Illinois points. Neither team shooting it very well. The two teams are combined 1 for 14 from 3. Points in the paint. We said that Southern Illinois needed Fay and Boyle to get something done in there. Evans is helping tonight as well. They've accumulated 8 points in the paint. And 7 offensive rebounds for Southern Illinois. That's saying something because Illinois State has been very good in that category all season long. As it stands, 25-17, Southern Illinois at halftime. Our Cardinal Glennon halftime report continues after this. Time out to congratulate this week's Missouri Valley Conference Crocs Player of the Week, and it is Shai Eli of the Evansville Purple Aces. The 6'4 senior has led the resurgence of Evansville basketball under Marty Simmons. He had a heck of a week. 18 points, 8 boards, 3 assists, 2 steals against Drake. And then against Southern Illinois, came back with 22 points and 6 boards, 18 points in the second half against the Salukis. Crocs, play hard, live comfortably.
Every time I step on the field.
On the court.
Every time I step on the track.
In the pool.
On the course.
Every time I step in the classroom, I am a champion.
I am a champion.
I am a champion.
I am a student.
I am an athlete.
I am a student athlete, and I am the Missouri Valley Conference.
I am the Missouri Valley Conference.
I am the Missouri Valley Conference.
The Missouri Valley Conference, celebrating athletic and academic excellence for more than 100 years.
Hi, this is Joe Buck for Centru Bank. Centru Bank has a simple pledge to help people achieve financial peace of mind. So whether you're a business customer or a personal banking customer, Centru Bank is ready to work for you with programs tailored to your unique needs. Call, come by, or visit us online at centru.com. Centru Bank, large bank benefits, community bank service.
Centru Bank, we are centered on you.
The year was 1964. The first Mustang rolls off the assembly line. LBJ becomes our president in a landslide victory over Goldwater. And Ed Emo introduces us to the original St. Louis-style pizza. And to celebrate 45 years in business, enjoy one of Emo's new 45th anniversary combo meals. A large one-topping pizza, an order of chicken wings, and an order of garlic cheese bread for just $19.95. 45 years of edge-to-edge value. Emo's, the square beyond compare.
One big part of Illinois State's start to the season, going 14-0, a school record to start the year, was Oregon transfer Champ Oguchi, fourth in the conference, averaging 15 points a game and 6 rebounds as well. It's time now for tonight's Purina Dog Chow Profile. Here's Kurt Pegler with a look at Champ Oguchi. A reminder, Purina Dog Chow, your pet, your passion.
Hey, throw your arm!
Transferring redshirt to that maturity.
File brought to you by Purina Dog Chow, your pet, our passion. 25-17 Southern Illinois, our Cardinal Glennon Children's Hospital halftime report will continue. Hang around, we'll be back after this.
So, Dad, can I borrow the car?
Where are you going?
Just to the movies.
Who's going?
Cassie and Dylan.
Dylan?
Yes, Dad, Dylan.
is growing up, whether you like it or not. That's why State Farm created the Steer Clear program. Teens learn safe driving, you get lower rates. When you're there, State Farm is there.
Where are you going?
Work.
The Valley needs you at the 2009 State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Women's Basketball Tournament. March 12th through 15th at the Family Arena in St. Charles, Missouri. Don't miss the Valley's Women's Basketball Event of the Season. Get your tickets now and make every team the home team in March.
Cameron UE brings you tonight's famous Valley alum, Illinois State's Doug Collins. Collins is the all-time leading scorer in Illinois State history. He was a member of the 1972 USA Olympic team. He's in the Valley Hall of Fame and a former number one draft pick of the Philadelphia 76ers. He played 8 years in the league and also coached in the NBA with Chicago, Detroit, and Washington. He also served as an analyst for the 2008 Beijing Olympic Games. Amron UE brings you Power On, a billion-dollar plan of action to increase reliability across Missouri.
If your basement or crawl space leaks when it rains, the reoccurring mess can be unbearable. Hang up that mop and put away the shop vac after calling Helitech. They install the Hydroway basement waterproofing system. A guaranteed solution. Call Helitech and
heal your home with Helitech.
Missouri Valley basketball snaps into focus on Fox Sports Midwest. The Drake Bulldogs. The Bradley Braves. Saturday at 8 Eastern, 7 Central on Fox Sports Midwest.
Tonight's Missouri Valley Conference basketball game is brought to you by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Bud Light, with just the right taste that never fills you up. The difference is drinkability. Diet Pepsi, the official soft drink of the Missouri Valley Conference. By Mercy Health Plans, the way we care makes all the difference. And by Casey's General Stores, convenience stores, and a whole lot more. It's time for tonight's Purina Dog Chow Profile. Purina Dog Chow, your pet, our passion. Here's Kurt Pegler with a look at Champo Gucci.
Even after a weekend filled with eating turkey, stuffing, and leftovers,
hey, throw your arm!
Champo Gucci is still hungry. Hungry to play after sitting and watching from the ISU bench last year.
A year is a long time to sit out for any player, and I think, you know, patience is the key, you know. And I think I've sat out and I've learned a lot, and I've really matured on and off the floor. I just missed the whole feeling of playing, competing in college basketball.
I think sitting out, transferring, redshirting adds to that maturity because you get to experience the college basketball season as an observer.
Now the Oregon transfer is gobbling up playing time and points. Through the season's first month, he is ISU's leading scorer. And he's enjoying the role of leading his team.
Guys are, you know, kind of looking up to me, and I have to lead by example. And, I have to lead these guys as a senior and as a player.
He's a big guard that can shoot it, he can score it anyway, and he can, you know, go on the post. And I think he's going to be a hard guard for a lot of teams because they have to try to find a guard big enough to, you know, match up with him.
Oguchi's legal first name is Chamberlain. He goes by Champ for short. And after leading ISU to tournament titles the past two weekends, Champ says he's just getting started.
I'd like to be an NCAA tournament champ, or a Missouri Valley Conference champ. I want to win all the championships.
I'm Kurt Pegler, reporting for the Missouri Valley Conference.
Only no points for Oguchi in the first half. Let's go to Charlie Spoonauer with head coach Tim Jankovic of Illinois State.
Tim, fouls and turnovers and
bad as we could play, as bad as we could possibly play. We had 14 turnovers and 100,000 fouls. We had all our guys in foul trouble. Could not have gone worse, but hopefully we can get our guys back and get settled down and play a much better half.
Good second half.
Thank you.
Our chat with the coaches all year brought to you by Mercy Health Plans, an innovative health management company empowering members to make healthy choices. The way we care makes all the difference. Champ Oguchi's back on the floor. He only played 4 minutes. First 4 minutes of the first half, down to the last 16. Now, here's the thing. Tim Jankovic was pretty calm, Charlie, and handled it pretty well. He's only down 8. It's not like he's down 28.
Well, you're right there, and he's got all his players back on the floor. He just has to hope that Oguchi doesn't try to do too much too quickly.
Illinois State started 3-for-3 from the field. They finished 3-for-15. Holloway deep inside. And get much better than that. It rolls off. Southern Illinois started 0-for-5 and finished 7-of-17.
In the first 4 minutes usually decides if the team's going to get back in the game. Pretty smart going right at Oguchi to see if they can pick up the third foul.
Bocott. There, 12 to shoot. Fay with trash and scores. That's a kick save.
But right now, you have to be thinking this may be Southern Illinois' night when those things happen.
Bears repeating. 98-9 in this building since 0-1-0, beginning of the 0-1-0-2 season. In the league in that span, 64-4. But two of those four losses have been this year, losing to Drake and Northern Iowa. Oguchi still scoreless.
If you're Southern, this is the way you want it. If you don't have a break, you come down, run some time, look inside.
Careless pass by Dillard doesn't do that a whole lot. And help from Oguchi. Osiris Eldridge. Hair hangs right with him.
Only three screens so far by Odiakosa.
Eldridge tip out by Odiakosa. Phillips finally a three for Illinois State, their first of the night.
And that's got to make them feel better and kind of breaks the ice and maybe gets the lid off for everyone.
We showed you in the first half on the road, much different than home in shooting threes. Hey, they get 9 threes per game on the average, Charlie. They lead the league. Dillard trying to answer.
Kind of a quick shot that time.
Oguchi fast. Still scoreless. Fay with a rebound. Dillard seems to be handling this point guard deal okay, filling in for Brian Mullins.
It's doing fine. Not many turnovers. There was a careless turnover just a moment ago, but that's the exception rather than the rule, although that was close right there.
Hare. Fay with position.
Oh,
nice play. Slinks under to get the stick back. He's got 8.
For Southern to win, and you mentioned it early, Mitch, the big guys have got to do something, and they have done it so far.
9-point lead for Southern Illinois. Oguchi triggers. There it goes. His first points of the night. He averages, well, he's second in the league in three threes per game. That's his 57th make of the year from bonus distance.
It's amazing how the three-point shot can catch you up in a game, isn't it?
You see it every night in college basketball. Every night.
Southern needs to keep getting looks at the basket, getting good looks and not turning the ball over. The game will be fine. Deep possession right here.
6 to shoot. Diller's going to have to take it. They're not going to get it off. Holloway reaching in. Fay, wrap around. They're going to call an intentional foul on Carlton Fay. Head of the half, Nelson, chicken wing on him.
I'm sure he did not mean to do that. Intentional foul
on Carlton Fay. 2 shots for Illinois State. We come back.
Everything worth listening to is now on Sirius XM. 69 commercial-free music channels. The most talk, news, and entertainment. Every major sport, new programming, new choices, new prices, over 130 channels. Add the best of Sirius to your XM subscription or the best of XM to your Sirius subscription free for 3 months. Hear what over 35 million listeners can't get enough of. Sirius XM.
The Missouri Valley Conference celebrates athletic excellence, bringing you nonstop red-hot collegiate basketball. There's another team in town that we're privileged to support, the Bob Costas Cancer Center at Cardinal Glennon Children's Hospital. The Cancer Center provides state-of-the-art technology, a child-friendly environment, and compassionate care to children who are diagnosed with cancer and other blood disorders. The Missouri Valley Conference and the Bob Costas Cancer Center. We're here for the kids. Give us a hand.
And as you'll see from our third quarter earnings, our performance is on the rise.
That's amazing. He didn't even flinch.
Yeah, typical cage fighter.
What?
He does this as a sideline. He'd rather be gouging somebody in the eye or putting his knee in somebody's kidney.
Ted.
Yeah, he has a bumper sticker that says, I'd rather have you in a chokehold.
He's like 5'7".
He's a bad man.
Tonight's Valley Flashback, a presentation of Coventry GHP, features Illinois State's first-round victory over Tennessee in the 1998 NCAA tournament in Sacramento, California. Redbirds trailed late 41-38, but they got on a roll. Rico Hill, Steve Hansel, Leroy Watkins, and then Dan Miller hit this layup to give Illinois State a 72-71 triumph for Coach Kevin Stallings. Coventry GHP, because your employees deserve a better health plan. Carlton Fay with a hard foul. Southern Illinois leading by six at the under 16 second half timeout. Let's take a look at this now on the open floor. Holloway headed for the basket.
Looks different from that angle, doesn't it?
This one will be the other angle.
There's the hug that we saw the first time. Contact may be initiated a little bit by the offensive play.
Okay. Now, for Illinois State, they got foul issues. We mentioned that. Look at this. Deuces are wild for Illinois State. And Heron Fay both have two now. We mentioned Southern Illinois with a much, much shorter bench. Only play eight guys. Holloway's got two shots here. And he's good at the line. In fact, he has made 21 of his last 24 foul shots for Tim Jankovic. That's his first point of the night, Charlie.
And all of a sudden, this is a four-point ball game. And the ball out of bounds on the baseline to the Redbirds.
And three would make it one. Or it looked like they had no chance to breathe.
There's your lob.
Evans goes to sleep. Odiakosa causes him for the slumber. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a four-point trip.
Nice little counter on the out-of-bounds play. Instead of stepping back, roll to the basket.
Nice job by Hare driving to the basket. Eldridge has got his third foul.
That's his third personal foul.
So turnabout's fair play. Southern Illinois went right at it. And Hare and Bocott both doing a good job at going at the basket. They tried the lob. And it's a hell ball.
Jump ball.
And Illinois State. Now Southern Illinois is going to keep it. But Jim Jankovic, who had to field gargling Pepto-Bismol in the first half, is thinking, I'm only down a possession.
Nick, get out,
ending this possession.
Uh-oh, offensive there. And that's going to be another one on Dillard. Is that going to be two for him?
Two on him.
His second personal foul. Second team foul on the Philippines.
We'll obviously see some zones for much of the second half because foul trouble is just huge.
We could see some empty chairs filled, too, toward the end of the game. Oguchi trying to get something rolling here. And all the way to the basket, Oguchi. His first two to go with the three. He's got five total.
And we have a tie here.
A 9-0 Illinois State run. That's enough for Chris Lowry. Circle the wagons and have a campfire meeting. 29-29, 5 minutes into the second half.
Arch Madness. It's not just great basketball. It's four action-packed days, nine exciting matchups, 10 Valley teams, 100 players, thousands of wild fans, and it all happens here during one wild weekend of basketball madness in St. Louis. It's the 2009 State Farm Missouri Valley Conference Men's Basketball Tournament, March 5th through 8th at Scott Trade Center. Arch Madness. It's the one weekend no basketball fan can miss. Get your tickets now.
Combining historic ambiance with modern comforts, the Sheraton St. Louis City Center Hotel & Suites has something for everyone.
Spread out in one of our beautifully appointed guest rooms. Relax at our indoor heated swimming pool or grab a bite to eat in Bistro 14, where our chef serves up American-styled entrees. With over 29,000 square feet of meeting space and a ballroom with spectacular views of the downtown skyline, our facilities are the choice for your next event. The Sheraton St. Louis City Center Hotel and Suites. You don't just stay here, you belong.
Did you know companies who advertise during economic uncertainty grew their sales 250% over companies who didn't? Now is the best time to advertise your product and services. Comcast Spotlight provides a cost-effective way to grow your business. Advertise on cable television and reap huge dividends on your investment. Maintaining brand awareness costs much less than rebuilding it. To advertise your business, call me, Janet Armstrong, or Jim Cahill.
Emmett, your gray facial hair has put you in a rocking chair.
Your beard is weird.
Just for Men Gel.
Gets rid of gray in 5 easy minutes.
His edge is back.
He scores!
Just for Men. Keep your edge.
Dry, itchy skin you can't ignore needs a lotion that does more. Gold Bond Lotion's medicated itch fighters relieve itch on contact, plus intensive moisturizers provide lasting relief. Look for the healing seal, Gold Bond Medicated Lotion. Stop itching. Start healing.
The final score tonight.
Tied up in Little Egypt, Illinois State, Southern Illinois, 2-inch state rival. Canelli basketball fans, go to NBC.org and click on the St. Louis Convention Visitors Commission logo for a chance to win 2 all-session tickets and overnight accommodations to the 2009 State Farm Valley Tournament Arch Madness. 2 tickets and an hotel room for Arch Madness. Register to win today by visiting NBC.org.
It's like a zone. It's like a little bit of a set action there.
Screen, Bocott. Oguchi with the rebound. He'll get 6 of those a game. Odiakosa. Oh. Nick Evans with the block. That is a dunk and a block tonight. Oguchi for 3. Rim rival. And Oguchi's fouling. Odiakosa's fouling. Over the back of Booker, and that's 3 on Odiakosa.
Nice block here. Not something you see as much of out of Evans as you would expect for someone with his size.
Missed 3 games earlier this year. How about the schedule that Chris Lowry played? He beat UMass, St. Mary's in a neutral 4. That's 2 great wins. He had to play Duke and UCLA back-to-back at the Garden. He lost to Western Kentucky and in Nevada. He had a tough non-conference
schedule. That non-conference schedule was hard. That was a 12th block for Nick Evans.
Evans. See if he made that basket. They might call off school.
Oh.
Offensive board. Clemens loses it. Off Illinois State.
Nearly the 3rd foul on Ryan Hare. Good hustle. Knocked loose. Sam Pay with good hustle. Ooh, close under the goal. Man.
Dillard, not many attempts. He's had to run the point with the injury to Brian Mullins.
That's what you cannot afford. And that wasn't a chance or an attempt to try to do something wild for himself. Evans was trying to make a basketball play for his team.
Chris Lowry will be at Arch Madness. Arch Madness fans can save big by stopping at any participating St. Louis area Taco Bell restaurant. Pick up a coupon good for $12 off any single session ticket. 2009 State Farm Valley Tournament for fans outside the St. Louis area, specifically in Des Moines, Springfield, Omaha, and Carbondale.
Whoa!
How about that for a call? Pick up your coupon for Arch Madness.
First turnover of the second half, and it comes back to bite Illinois State in the basket.
2-point lead, Illinois State, and immediately Emmanuel Holloway comes back to tie it.
Get off
It's been an ebb and flow game, but you get the sense this is headed for some nitty-gritty here pretty soon.
Someone's going to have to hit a basket or two from the three.
Like that. Dillard.
Dillard's the one guy for sure you would guard from three if you're Illinois State.
And a three the other way. Oguchi starting to warm up for Illinois State.
Well, you can see why they need Champ Oguchi in the ball game.
These two teams were one for 19 for three. Now there's three threes in a row.
I'm going to repeat. You would guard Dillard, number one, and you would guard Oguchi on this other end.
Oguchi starting to get heated up. How about Dillard just zinging two threes in and immediately getting up to 10 points? Dillard wants another one. Wow, close. Wait a minute, this is going to be on Oguchi.
Oh, my.
Against Booker, and that's three on Champ Oguchi. That will get the attention of Tim Jankovic. Starting to warm up. Three-point lead for the home team.
You know, it's not all fun and games when you're a mascot.
Every year I find myself where the season always ends meets the bills never stop.
You know that place where you realize even a squirrel can't live off peanuts? Well, maybe you don't, but believe me, I'm there.
Here's a way to score on savings.
Nice.
Switch your car insurance to State Farm. You'll save big, plus get a payment plan that fits your budget. Call, click, or visit and start saving today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You know I wear this everywhere.
If I were you, I'd expect lavish guest rooms and gorgeous lake views from a Four Diamond Hotel. If I were you, I'd expect to be entertained, wined and dined. And if I so choose, pampered by day or exhausted by night. And if I were you, I'd want it all. Very close, yet seemingly far away. Chateau on the Lake Resort and Spa. More than you expect. Closer than you think.
Connecting Missouri with 27,000 miles of power lines means each and every mile must be reliable. Because when the skies turn dark, every mile must show its strength. We're Ameren UE, working every day, improving our delivery system. UE, ratcheting up our routine so you can enjoy undisturbed comfort in yours. Learn how we're improving reliability at uepoweron.com.
I always told them I'd take them on a trip around the world. I just didn't tell them we'd do it all in a weekend. It's all within reach at ExploreSt.Louis.com.
Fueled by threes from Kevin Dillard, Southern Illinois leads 37 to 34. It's time now for this Valley Date in History brought to you by the Sheraton St. Louis City Center Hotel. Illinois State set a school record on this date, 1984, with 35 free throws as the Redbirds won at West Texas State, 93-82. The Sheraton City, St. Louis City Center, you don't just stay there, you belong. And if you can shoot 35 free throws in Canyon, Texas on the road, it's doing something. Used to be a long old road trip in this league to West Texas State, now West Texas A&M. Booker. Boyle fights. Phillips comes out of there and a lead down the floor. Quick transition. Something Southern Illinois had prevented Illinois State from doing was getting any flow transition-wise in the first half.
They got, I think, one basket in the first half running. So now this is two this half.
Should be 37 Southern Illinois, 36 Illinois State. And a chance now for That is the correct score with 10:54 to go in the game. Holloway making his presence felt. One-point lead for Southern Illinois at the 10:42 mark.
Back to man defense after the threes.
Dillard inside the three-point line this time. He had 22 against Drake in a game I had earlier this year. Again, in league play, he's averaging 15 points a game.
Nice.
Sam Pay. The bonus two for Illinois State. 39-38, Southern Illinois, midway through the second half.
The baskets have come a little easier for both ball clubs here of late.
8 second half points for Kevin Dillard. Strong curl to the basket, counted for two. That time he gave up the ball, came off ball, Charlie, to get strong off ball move.
Nice curl.
Eldridge, quick stop and pop.
Challenger, that's just a very good athlete and a good shot.
Foul on Illinois State.
John
Phillips.
It's
his first, four team fouls. In the second half on Tim Jankovic's team, down one possession with 9:24 to go in the game. And Landon Shipley is in the game now for Illinois State. Dillard has Southern Illinois' last 10 points. He's got the ball in his hands now. He joined us late, Brian Mullins, the great lead guard for Southern Illinois for 4 years. Out with a fractured foot. Out indefinitely. Shipley played at Austin Peay initially, gets the rebound, and he gets pounded by Bocock.
Good guard rebound that time, and then Bocock gets a not a really good foul.
Shipley, you knew him, played at Lafayette High School in St. Louis.
And our basketball camps.
So you made some money off Shipley.
Money well spent.
Oguchi creates the contact. Evans hangs right there. Southern Illinois, one-point lead and possession.
Good job defensively that time to slow Dillard down.
He thought about pulling quick. Yes. Foul on Shipley. This year it's an absolute, Charlie. There is no judgment. You get two hands on a dribbler, it's an automatic foul this year in college basketball.
I watched Northern Iowa the other night, and they did a really good job of keeping their hands back and away. That's a hard thing to do because you spend so much time touching people.
Whistles are blown, and Sam Pay's got a problem. That's his third foul.
Foul on 41, Brandon Sam Pay, his third personal foul. 16 foul on the red bird.
Southern Illinois is one foul away from the bonus. And a long way to go at 8:29. Whoa. Trey takes it off the face from Evans. And it's sped up. This is a pretty good place to go if you're Southern Illinois. Dillard. Good defense. Holloway. And they're going to say last touch by Kevin Dillard of the Salukis. Off his head. Good call.
Dillard's played, Mitch, all but a couple of minutes of this ball game.
Eldridge.
That's right.
And I'm telling you, he got that corner turn and was strong with the dribble when he turned the corner.
when he chooses to, Mitch, he can either get to the basket or can pull up and get, there's your acceleration you talked about. There's the bump.
That was a big time move.
And he can make his, he can make himself a three or an inside the three-point line at his own choosing.
He has been quiet tonight. Just 8 points, six under his average, fifth in the league in scoring. Had a couple double-doubles this year, four in his career. At Bradley, he had 17 points and 10 rebounds in a loss against their I-74 rivals. They came back to avenge that loss Saturday at Redbird Arena.
Clemens back in the ballgame, and he's given the team a lift a couple of times, usually by driving it at the goal. See if he does that.
Eldridge, two free throws. He's in double figures, has 10, and the game has now flipped to Illinois State's advantage. One-point lead for the Redbirds at 42-41.
Dillard's getting a screen.
He likes this shot.
Guard rebound again, Mitch.
Holloway quick to the other end. Sanpei, no finish. And that's where Holloway put mayonnaise, mustard, lettuce, and everything he could on the sandwich. Still nobody eats. Faye, offensive foul.
You may not like the call if you're from Southern Illinois, but that's the same call they made earlier in the game.
Chris Lowry didn't particularly like it.
It's all good at Casey's General Stores. Right now, buy any large specialty pizza and get any medium single topping pizza for only $8.
Made fresh for your order. Meat and cheese piled high for you. Casey's General Store. Casey's, it's all good.
You ready, Axel?
Your dog's one of a kind.
Good boy.
And now, you have the power to help significantly extend his healthy years. A groundbreaking 14-year study by Purina proves that Puppy Chow, then Dog Chow Nutrition, fed properly over a lifetime,
ready, Axel?
Can help extend his lovable antics up to 1.8 healthy years.
Faster, Axel, faster!
Long live your buddy. Woo-hoo! Long live your dog. Purina Puppy Chow and Purina Dog Chow.
Did you know companies who advertise during economic uncertainty grew their sales 250% over companies who didn't? Now is the best time to advertise your product and services. Comcast Spotlight provides a cost-effective way to grow your business. Advertise on cable television and reap huge dividends on your investment. Maintaining brand awareness costs much less than rebuilding it. To advertise your business, call me, Janet Armstrong, or Jim Cahill.
So this is another opportunity to take the foundation, take these young men, and build them their lives and build something special.
Right, when I came in and took this position, I said, this is what we're going to do, and this is where we're going to be. This program is solid. It is successful. You're going to see that determination and that defensive intensity on the floor.
Now 7:23 to go in the game at participating Schnucks and Hy-Vee's grocery stores in the St. Louis and Valley markets. Arch Madness fans can obtain a coupon good for two single session tickets at Scott Trade Center for a total of $15 combined with the proof of purchase of a 17.6 pound bag of Purina Dog Chow. That's right, two State Farm Valley tournament tickets for $15. And here's how you find out more details. Go to archmadness.com, archmadness.com, and get ready for Arch Madness. These two teams know all about it. Illinois State last year got to the finals under Tim Jankovic. And, of course, Southern Illinois has had just a brilliant Arch Madness history throughout their storied basketball history.
Air's going to get after Schiffer here.
Sam Pay, all kinds of foul trouble, both teams. Evans, decent defense, out of bounds, and there were five Salukis near the ball and could not save it.
Couldn't save it. Effort is there.
She's like the Titanic, just not enough lifeboats to save everybody. Evans tried, might have let Dillard do it. Illinois State, 1 point lead on the ball.
Sam Pay almost picked up the foul.
Gucci in the weave. Pay touched it. Pay touched it last. .648 to go.
Ooh, close to a hole there.
Holloway. Decent second half, and Fay gets the rebound.
Only four salutes on the board that time. They got out of it.
They'll oar the lifeboat to the other end, see if they can score here, down one.
Well, here's a pretty good man with the ball.
And here's where not having Mullins, you're not rubbing Dillard off screens. Now you can get it to him off ball. Dillard. Bucket.
Sam Pay did not show on the ball screen. Look at this right here. Here comes the screen by Evans. Sam Pay's off in the middle of the lane. You've got to step out and get that young man.
The three will count. The foul occurs after
the foul over the basket. Was on
the basket.
Gucci,
yeah. So you got all kinds of trouble here if you're at Illinois State. A three made by Dillard, a fourth foul on Gucci, and it is after the basket, meaning the one-and-one comes into play. So Fay gets one plus the penalty. This can be a five-point trip and a fourth foul on Champo Gucci.
As you mentioned earlier, Fay's like 78% from the line. So,
and two for two in this game. Only had 4 points in the game at Illinois State.
And no rebounds in the game at Illinois State. Tonight he's got six already.
Curious how good he can be the next 2 years if he continues to work at his game and particularly get a little more inside maybe with his game.
He's certainly strong enough. His upper body strength is excellent.
5 point trip for Southern Illinois and a fourth foul on Gucci. 46-42 Southern Illinois. The 6 minute mark to go in the game. And a give and go steal. .17 Redbird turnovers.
Everybody decided to guard Dillard that time. He had help coming from everywhere.
I like Dillard, Charlie. I like him the first time I saw him. I like him every time I see him. And he's got basketball instinct.
10. Oh, that's awful early to shoot that one.
Off Illinois State. They get rescued. Did the ball hit the rim? Question. They've reset the 35-second shot clock. And now they're going to ask here.
Apparently they see they're fielding a good. Yes.
They said touch the rim. Fresh 35 for Dillard on the inbounds. Dillard, what a second half he's having. 20, Charlie. 20 for Kevin Dillard. He's closing in on another career high.
Holloway just didn't close out on him.
Mr. Illinois basketball. He's had great company with that award. 16 of the last 18 Southern Illinois points belong to Kevin Dillard.
Well, we wondered if he was going to step up. I guess we found out the answer to that.
Holloway didn't exactly close out on him, really.
Not as he should have, because this second half has belonged to Dillard. Three.
Egyptian dogs are barking tonight in Little Egypt with Kevin Dillard doing most of the barking. Let's take a look now at our scores from around the valley, brought to you by Casey's General Stores, convenience stores, and a whole lot more. All right. Creighton leading Drake at Drake. Drake beat Creighton at Creighton earlier. Missouri State by two over Marty Simmons' Evansville team, much improved. And Wichita State has won on the road. They get a 6-point win on the road. That's their fifth league win.
Wichita State's coming, Mitch, and they're not going to be any fun for anyone when they get to tournament time.
They've got some talent on that team. Clements called for the foul.
Some of the fans disagree with that, but that's the same call they've made all night long. We've talked about it. It's a point of emphasis. Hand checking.
He made an absolute. Both teams now in the bonus the rest of the way. And foul trouble. Unset of 5 minutes to go. Dillard, 16. Second half points, including four threes. Eldridge, out of bounds off Eldridge, and he's down.
And he's hurt.
Osiris Eldridge goes down hard underneath the basket.
Here's your drive. Splits people right here, and he seems to be in pretty good shape. Until he planted his leg.
Ooh, this doesn't look good. We saw him getting taped up. Weren't they taping his ankle?
They were taping the ankle.
Yeah, he turned his ankle right there, and that looks like the one they were taping.
At some point, you got 4:41 to go. Oguchi's going to have to come back, I think.
He's got four fouls. So you got to be real careful when you bring him back. And they're going to try to get Eldridge on the floor as quick as they can.
Well, here's Oguchi. Here's Oguchi back. That makes sense.
Quick. You just got to be careful. Well, they're trying to see if his knee's okay.
Well, he's talking to people next to him. Seems like he's handling it all right. Big defensive stand this time for Illinois State.
Dillard has been the show. 20 points, 16 in the second half, four threes. Fay.
Close.
Phillips trying to get something off the high screens. Harris stays right with him.
Needs to find Oguchi while he still only has four fouls.
Bocott handing him. 13 to shoot. Illinois State restarts. Lob. Odiakosa. Nick Evans says hello for the second time tonight.
And time tonight for the big fella.
Maybe he learned that homeschool. Maybe his mom taught him how to do this. Osiris Eldridge headed to the locker room. Illinois State's got issues.
Where can you get the best milk? From Tom, from Russ, from Laura, and Maggie.
It comes from all of us.
We're Prairie Farms, and we don't just work for the dairy. We are the dairy, making sure the milk in your child's school, in your stores, and on your table is fresh and healthy, handled with the kind of care that your family deserves.
We are Prairie Farms Dairy.
Ask for us, the farmer-owned dairy.
I know this drill. I rack up a big charge on my credit card. I get a tote bag.
Well, actually, with our points program, you can get gift cards, flat-screen TVs, even plane tickets.
How do you get enough points for that?
Oh, all kinds of ways. By using your debit card, your credit cards, checking account.
I don't believe you.
What?
You're messing with me, right?
No, I'm not messing with you.
Can I still get the tote bag?
Absolutely.
It's not just banking. It's National City.
Some of the most important decisions you make happen every day without much thought, and they can impact the rest of your life. Good decisions affecting your health can also happen outside of your doctor's office. They're made when you decide to work out or not, when you choose what to eat. We believe the more you know, the better choices you can make. Mercy Health Plans is here to help you with access, information, and guidance so you can make the best choices for your health. Mercy Health Plans, the way we care makes all the difference.
If your basement or crawl space leaks when it rains, the reoccurring mess can be unbearable. Hang up that mop and put away the shop vac after calling Helitech. They install the Hydroway basement waterproofing system. A guaranteed solution. Call Helitech and
heal your home with Helitech.
Tonight on the FM
SSN final score presented by DirecTV. Chris Paul leads the Hornets against Darren Williams and the Jazz. And Big 12 rivals collide in Kansas. Missouri takes on the Jayhawks. All the day's highlights in 30 minutes. It's the final score.
Time now to check in with our Valley Trivia question tonight, brought to you by the Hilton at the Ballpark. For your next trip to St. Louis, stay in the center of it all at the Hilton at the Ballpark, located next to Busch Stadium. Which Valley school is the only team to win three straight State Farm Valley Tournament Championships? And yes, in 93, 94, and 95, it was the Southern Illinois Invitation. Rich Herron had some great teams. For more information on the Hilton at the Ballpark, go to experiencestlouis.com. Part of those teams in that three-year run, little point guard by the name of Chris Lowry.
And Coach Heron's at the ballpark tonight.
He is
here, came down and saw me at halftime. Help me with the questions.
5 seconds to shoot here for Illinois State. They try to lob it. Odiakosa, Osiris Eldridge back in the game. Phillips. Foul. And it's going to be on Southern Illinois. Great hustle. Fay is called for the foul. He's got four. Still 3:48 to go, Charlie.
3:48 to Tim Jankovic is going really quickly. And it's like one of those sand glasses for Chris Lowry right now.
He's going to get two shots here. Chris Lowry is arguing it should be one and one. Holloway's going to get a pair.
Made the first one anyway, so.
Chris Lowry, again, the only player in Valley history to win the tournament as a player and as a coach. He's dropped 40 pounds, Chris Lowry. Emmanuel Holloway, second foul shot good. He's got all 8 points in the second half. And Illinois State cuts it to five. 49-44, Southern Illinois.
Oh, that was close right there. You need to defend without fouling if you're Illinois State. And Eldridge must be healthy. They've got him on Dillon.
Still 12 to shoot. Hare takes a look at it. Got to find Dillard. There they find him.
Oh, nice.
Blocked by Odiakosa.
Big play by Odiakosa. And a good offensive play by Southern Illinois.
Noguchi with four fouls. And Hare active on the defensive end. Let's take a look at tonight's reset. Made possible Emerson, the global manufacturing and technology company. To learn more, visit Emerson.com. Emerson, consider it solved. Both teams in the bonus. Both teams have three timeouts. Hare with the board for Southern Illinois. The Salukis 5-point lead and a chance to extend it. Under three to go.
Here we have a timeout on the court. Timeout charge.
Good timeout right here. You can get Fay back in the ball game on for offense. And I think that, yeah, they are. That helps your offense. Going to talk about what you're going to run right now if you're Chris Lowry on the offense. Your defense is going to stay the same. But what you're going to do, use a little clock.
And Chris Lowry good in these situations. Although this team has not been involved in very many close games. They've only had two games decided by 2 points or less. You and I had one of them because they thought they had Creighton beaten Omaha twice.
And I thought they had them beat twice also.
Three foul shots, down three at the end of regulation, took the game for Creighton into overtime. And then Dillard had the ball taken away from him in the corner in the overtime.
And a three Creighton resulted. Yeah, remember,
and
the
then
three came out of that.
Yeah, Dostler stole it. And Southern Illinois had one slip away in Omaha tonight. Trying to beat Illinois State, who's 7-4 in the league, trying to stay within arm's length of Northern Iowa, who has won 11 straight league games to be 11-1.
Under 10 on the shot clock.
Hare.
Ooh.
Rob. Illinois State down five. Still with a shot with 2:21 to go.
And how do you get a shot for Gucci or Eldridge would be the question.
Phillips going to open the floor. Offensive foul. Fay took the charge.
Phillips has had that disease in the first half. But here it is again. He's going to try to dump it off to Oliokosa. Angle's bad and just runs right in there.
And Eldridge or Oguchi never touched
it. They surely did.
Now Southern Illinois trying to milk this clock a little bit.
Under 2 minutes right now. It's still an awful long time for a young team. You've got four freshmen and a sophomore out there right now for Southern Illinois. And that freshman.
Oh, offensive foul. Dillard called for the charge. Holloway took it.
Seven on the shot clock and he took it, so that part of it was good.
But Illinois State stays within two possessions.
This is almost a time you've got to say 0 and 25 are going to touch the basket.
I was going to say, you can ask the same question you asked the last time. They didn't get a touch it the last time. Not going to touch it this time either. Yes, they will.
Oh, man.
Headaches.
Good hustle then by both sides. Eldridge is trying to settle everybody down, but I'm not sure that anybody's listening very closely.
Phillips wants a ball screen. Phillips wants a shot. Phillips has a shot and a basket and a foul.
I'm not sure that that's exactly the way you draw it up, but it works pretty well, and you've got a guy that's shooting over 75% now after a great drive at the basket and a foul out, I think, for
Faye,
which hurts you on the other end.
Double jeopardy.
Surely is. And now you can get, if you're Illinois State, within two.
Phillips is well-traveled. He was the freshman of the year in the Jayhawk Conference at Allen County Community College in Iola, Kansas, which is saying something in that league when you're the freshman of the year.
Yes, surely is.
Then he went to Iowa Western in Council Bluffs, Iowa. That time, he went to the basket, and he got a three-point trip out of it. This is a two-point game.
Charge, it sure is.
Yeah. Sampei takes the charge.
Sampei takes the charge.
It's four on Dillard.
People may disagree with Mr. Skiles there, but I believe he was correct, Mitch.
Three of the last four possessions have ended charging fouls. And Illinois State can tie with a two, take the lead with a three with 75 seconds to play. Phillips, what do we got here? Foul on Boyle.
Phillips
on Dillard. He's fouled out. Dillard has fouled out of the game, Charlie. Fay is gone. Dillard is gone. And that is a real problem for Southern Illinois.
Here's the drive at the basket. And the reach in. Yeah, there's contact, Nick.
That's where
it looks like it.
But that's where Dillard has got to learn. With four fouls, he's got to be on the floor. At the very least, if you give up a basket, it's time. Now, all of a sudden, somebody's going to have to play the point guard who hasn't played the point guard all year.
Who do you think? Bocott or Clemens?
This guy.
Hare?
Put Mullins in with his boot and first.
With his boot, I'd take him.
Shirt, tie, and everything else.
Phillips, again, as we said, 76%, and he's hit at least two in a row here.
He's got three in a row for the game. And double figures with 10. Hit 15 against Southern in the game 11 days ago. Boom and boom.
You got to admire a guy that can stand in there and shoot free throws like that.
Game is tied, and Southern Illinois does not have a point guard in the last 108.
On offense or defense. Now, Hare can guard people.
I'm telling you, Chris Lowry's holding his breath right now.
1 minute remaining to play.
Can he get it across the timeline? He did.
Now you're all right because you're down in your half-court offense. Clemens going at the basket, Mitch, is maybe a possibility.
You got a possession, basically, in the difference. You got 33 seconds. So even if Chris Lowry runs his clock all the way down and scores, you'd have almost a complete possession for Illinois State to try to answer.
And if you miss, you got a tie game, and Illinois State will probably not have to give the ball back. So defense here and stop, huge.
Tim Jankovic, this is one of those games this team can't play much worse than they did in the first 20 minutes for sure. And they got a shot at winning this game.
Second half, they've played so much better.
Play better. They're 18-4 this year. Rob Judson is assistant coach, former head coach at Northern Illinois.
Don't get an illegal screen here.
Where does Chris Lowry go for this bucket?
Hare's not a bad idea.
He's on the left side. Bocock. Not going to get it off.
No. Nope.
And Illinois State can take it all the way down to the nub because you got
time
a one-possession game.
I would guess timeout.
Yeah. Tim Jankovic wants a full timeout with 25.8 left. And he can take it all the way down to the end.
And he should. This should go. I mean, if I'm Illinois State and somebody shoots that before the last 4 or 5 seconds.
We have a long talk tomorrow on the bus ride home. Let's take a look at our players of the game brought to you by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Lloyd Phillips. And 11 points. If he doesn't make the plays he made at the end, Illinois State's not in this position.
No, and he hit the free throws. That's not easy to do. Not easy to do at this point in the game. He's going hard here, and this is the one he makes and fouls out. Okay, and that's a huge part of the play, too, getting him out of the ballgame.
And for Southern Illinois, it is fabulous freshman Kevin Dillard. 20 points, 16 in the second half, 4 threes, all of those in the second half, couple of assists. And his threes got Southern Illinois going in the second half.
Oh, he was good. Sam Pay obviously didn't react well on that. But the young man knows what he's doing. He had 2 fouls in about a 10-second stretch, Mitch. He had the charge here at half court, then the reach on the other end. Now, no road wins. Last 4 times out for the Redshirts. So can they handle the basketball and can they do this? This is a hard thing to execute right here.
But Tim Jankovic has options. One of them is the guy throwing the ball in, Osiris Eldridge. Into our player of the game, Phillips.
Way too early yet now. I agree with what they're doing right now.
If they start their play at 10.
That's who I'd want to have it. Yeah, good defense right there.
Eldridge loses Hare. Osiris Eldridge. No.
No.
We're going to overtime, and Southern Illinois is going to have to play an extra 5 minutes without a point guard. Has put 5 on the clock with a 49-49 tie. Kevin Dillard's going to petition Congress to try to get an extra 5 minutes. He doesn't get it. He is disqualified.
Ooh-wee.
Get ready for 5 more minutes, 49-49 here in Carbondale.
They got everything.
Not everything.
That's not mine.
Yo, Rich, he said he saw two guys earlier. One of them was wearing a jacket.
And how does that help me?
Yo, you cover for this?
I don't know.
How could you not know?
Yo, it's not funny.
This is funny. You know what? You need to call my agent.
You should know you're covered.
Come on, man. It's not mine.
Call one of our 17,000 State Farm agents today.
I hear what you're saying. I just don't do commercials. It's not my thing.
Conan, this is different. It's a ton of money, and it's only going to be seen in Sweden.
Only in Sweden?
All the Hollywood guys do this. This one commercial couldn't hurt.
Bud Light.
Vroom, vroom, der Party Starter.
Vroom, vroom, Party Starter.
That wasn't me.
Vroom, vroom, body starter.
Body starter.
Basically, it's about symmetry.
I'm good.
Be honest here, man.
Ah, fuck it.
I'm good.
My bad. I'm good.
I'm late!
I'm good.
Ready?
No.
Men can take anything.
I'm good.
Except the taste of Diet Cola. Until now, Pepsi Max, the first Diet Cola for men.
Good.
Southern Illinois has only got 8 players. 2 of those have fouled out. 49-49 tie as we go to overtime. All right, now here's how it ended. Here's our regulation ended, Charlie.
I thought this was a great idea. Banana cut by Osiris Eldridge, one-on-one on this side of the floor. He can make that shot, Mitch. That's a good shot for him. The ball just didn't go in the goal. Credit Harris. Good defense by Harris.
Illinois State, this is their 3rd overtime game. They're 1-1. Southern Illinois, their 2nd. They are 0-1. First possession of the overtime will be Illinois State's. The game tied at 49. Gucci floats. Strong rebound for Anthony Booker.
Gucci came in and got some baskets, got 8 points fairly quickly. It's kind of cool since then.
Well, these are your 5 because the only other guy eligible is Big Nick Evans.
They're all right on fouls. 3 on Bocott, so that's not really an issue right now.
In fact, Illinois State's got the issue on the other one. Strong move, Boyle. Cat fisherman gets fouled. He's going to get 2 shots.
And that will be 4 on Odiokosa.
He's got 4. Gucci has 4.
Gucci almost stuck his hand in the cookie jar.
And Boyle, who has not scored tonight. Tony Boyle, averaging 9 points a game. He's at 14 points 3 times this season. That's his first point of the game. Well, he was good a couple years ago in that Sweet 16 run. In fact, he helped him out on an opening round win over Holy Cross. He had 15 points. And they were very close to beating Kansas to go to the Elite Eight. 2 foul shots down, Boyle. Carlton Fay applauds. He's fouled out. Creighton has won at Drake, so they go to 8-4. Eldridge loses this. Hare with just enough defense.
Hare will get after you now.
Missouri State has beaten Evansville in Springfield. And Wichita State won on the road at Terre Haute against Indiana State. So Illinois State trying to keep pace with Creighton.
Ooh. And this turnover there.
Bradley lost last night. They're 7-5. Creighton now 8-4. Northern Illinois 11-1. Strip.
Here's a block, I'll bet you.
Booker, but Holloway follows.
Well, you got to get everybody on the defense to run down the floor. Because if that thing gets blocked, don't let the offense follow it up.
51-51 tied. The 3:28 mark. It is tied at 51 apiece.
Well, walk on Boyle. Leaning back when he caught the basketball.
And Boyle did good things the last trip, bad things this time. Lowry. You can see him in the middle of the screen. Not really thrilled. Now where does Illinois State go? Phillips. Osiris Eldridge.
There's a shot that Illinois State usually wants, but on the road it hasn't gone for.
That's the key, Charlie. That shot's going down in normal. At Redbird Arena, and it ain't going down on the road.
You'd almost like to see Booker with a basketball. I realize he's a freshman. He comes off the bench. He's got a Gucci with four fouls.
Bocott had a good first half, yet to score in the second half. This is a problem. Lemon regains.
He's going to get to the goal.
Southern Illinois won a goaltending. They're going to get it. A late goaltending call. They're going to say Odiakosa. Listen, Clemens had nothing going as he rounded turn three.
No, that is.
Let's see where his hand is here. Yeah, he got it in the rim. That's a good call.
Oh, it's in the rim.
Yeah, it's inside.
Oh, it surely is. How about that?
Excellent call by
the officials. How about the officials?
Clemens ends up with 2 points, and there is a foul on Southern Illinois. Booker.
Gucci, I know they're closing quick on him, Mitch, but he doesn't seem as though he's looking for that shot, for the three. Misses two shots here. You see him, the ref, the official explaining it to Odiakosa.
Oguchi gets two shots here, both teams in the double bonus. Oguchi tied for fourth in the league at 83% in foul shooting. Oh. Front roll. Had some big nights, 29 against Drake, 28 at SMU. Not so much tonight, that's just his 10th point, but two very important points. As the game tied at 53 with 2:23 to go in the overtime.
Stops become important now both ways, but particularly for a road team.
Illinois State has not missed a free throw tonight. They're 16 of 16 at the foul stripe. Last touch by Eldridge. Got a fingernail on it. Southern Illinois keeps it. Again, Southern Illinois doing this without a point guard. Brian Mullen's not playing tonight. Kevin Dillard's fouled out.
Good defense right here.
Bocott, all arms and legs. Hair. Bucket.
Nice. Really good possession for the home team.
That is Hare's first field goal of the night to go with two free throws. I'm impressed with the way Southern is handling this without a point guard. Oguchi. Southern thought he walked. Instead, it's a basket and an and one for Champ Oguchi.
Chance to take the lead. You wonder, Mitch, why Oguchi doesn't drive a lot. He's such a good three-point shooter. Why? But, man, he's strong, and when he gets to the goal, he finishes. Bump, still in.
They want to get the foul correct, I believe. They call it on Hare.
I didn't think so.
Boyle gets the foul. Tony Boyle. This would give Illinois State the lead. Oguchi, three-point play, 13 points. And it is a 56-55 lead for Illinois State. 56-55 Illinois State. From here, I travel to Springfield, the Queen City of the Ozarks. There's a women's game in the Valley, and that'll be Friday night. Great. Jim Flannery's done a great job with that team. They're not playing a lot of kids either at Missouri State with a young team trying to retool. That'll be 7:30 at the new JQH Arena. It'll be my first time there and looking forward to it. Then on Saturday, the men get cranked up again, and I'll be at this game as Drake hosts the Bradley Braves at the Knapp Center. Drake, last year's Wonder Kids. Awesome story last year. This year now, after a great start here, they won at this arena earlier in January. They're starting to leak oil. They lost tonight at home to Creighton.
Just have not shot the ball as well as they did early in the year. When they were knocking off Iowa and all those folks, they were really shooting the ball, and their zone was a mystery to people.
The mystery has been figured out for the time being. And what will Southern Illinois do? They have gone to some, well, it's just the Southern in the overtime. Tony Boyle had not scored in the game. He gets two free throws. Hare had not had a field goal in the game. He just got a big bucket. Clemens had not had a second half point until the two he got, and that was kind of out of control goaltend on Odiakosa. Now where do you get points with Kevin Dillard and Carlton Fay fouled out of the game?
I'm not sure. But I haven't been sure about a lot of things tonight. Bocott has done a nice job of handling the basketball. That's one thing for sure. Booker has nearly had two plays develop in front of him, but Eldridge knocked it out of his way one time, and the other time somebody banged it out. So maybe one of those guys. When you're home, sometimes good things happen for you.
Particularly in this place where you're 64-4 against the league. I'm going to tell you, this is hard for Chris Lowry. You got to really, really coach.
Well, these kids of his have done a great job of answering the bell tonight with Brian Mullins sitting over there with that ski boot on.
Big time. Illinois State, 1-point lead. Southern with the ball. Minute 27 to go in the game.
Hare doing a nice job running the ball club here. Whoa.
Eldridge trying to put on the acetylene on him.
There's your play right. Oh, almost.
Boyle, the senior. No, leaves it thin. And a rebound to Illinois State. Southern Illinois does not have to foul. They can defend the shot clock.
Absolutely. There's no reason to foul. Now you've got young kids, though, and you have to worry about something like that.
Oguchi around Booker.
Oh, bad shot.
Quick, bad shot, and a rebound for Southern Illinois.
That one, Illinois State did not need.
13-second differential. Foul. Phillips. Two shots for Justin Bocott.
And the foul comes as a result of hands-on-man dribbling the basketball. You can't tag people. There's the tag.
Bocott has yet to score in the second half. He had 7 points in the first half. He is 4 of 6 at the line.
Oh, whoa.
What'd you say about good things happening at home?
At home.
When you're 98-9 at home, that's what happens.
That's how you get to be 98-9.
This would give Southern Illinois the lead.
Right in the middle. Well, you go down now and you take your first good shot.
Oguchi three. For three. Odiakosa tips it in. Odiakosa tips it in. It's a 1-point lead for Illinois State. Still time, 20 seconds for Southern Illinois.
Now you've got no point guard, and this makes it a little harder.
Driving Bocott. No. Illinois State. And a foul with 9.5 to go.
Foul on Wesley Clemens, his third personal foul.
Clemens fouls, two shots at the other end for Illinois State.
But Bocott got into the lane.
Let's take a look at Dean Odiakosa's tip.
After this long, long three, it goes straight up. Beautiful.
He had the goaltend earlier. He's got redemption. Oguchi with two.
Well, now you're going to look at strategy again.
Time out of the
because if this goes to three, you still got 9 seconds. That's too early to foul. That's too early to foul and give somebody two free throws.
But of the guys on the floor left, only one has hit a three tonight. That's Bocock. And he's 31% from three. Hare's 36%.
Well, you've got good enough athletes if you're Illinois State. Now, this all is dependent on him hitting this free throw. But you've got good enough athletes to switch every screen. You know, that's what most people do in this situation. They switch every screen and go ahead and keep a hand in the face.
Illinois State, Charlie, has gone to the foul stripe tonight 18 times. They have made 18 free throws.
Well, this one right here is kind of important.
In fact, the Redbirds tonight turned it over 21 times. Most of those were in the first half. They've only hit three threes, 3 of 16 from three, and yet they got a shot at winning this game.
That was some real analyst work, wasn't it? They need to hit this free throw. That's why we get the big bucks.
Missouri State at Southern Illinois was the last team better than 10 of 10. That was 16 of 16, the Bears.
Ahern?
That'd have been Ahern and his band of thieves. He had some other guys on that team that could shoot free throws. Booker's still back here. I think they got to line up for Booker forgot that there's one more free throw.
I thought Booker was going to do the deal. I think it was the Wake Forest guy that did the other day. He hit on the other end. Huge free throw right here.
Oguchi's 4 of 4 in the overtime. Three-point game. Southern Illinois needs a three.
Everybody better guard.
There. Bocott to tie it. Off. Southern Illinois with 0.6 seconds to go. And we have had Chris Lowry twice this year with excruciatingly painful losses.
Creighton, absolutely.
And this one. Give credit to Tim Jankovic and the Illinois State Redbirds. They sneak one away here tonight. Let's take a look now at our play of the game brought to you by Rawlings, the official athletic equipment of the Missouri Valley Conference. Odiakosa's tip-in.
Jumps up and knocks that thing in. High bounce, and he just gets up and gets a great tip in, Mitch. And that's after he had had the goaltending. So he had to, that was a great one.
Illinois State goes to 8-4. They stay tied with Creighton, who won tonight at Drake. They're 8-4. Northern Iowa's at 11-1. An exciting game tonight in overtime, won by Illinois State on the road. For Charlie Spooner, I'm Mitch Holtis. Enjoy the rest of your Valley Basketball Week. Due to the